Hello, Mr. Alcazar. I got your return job in. It's been about 10 years since I serviced this. I think might be a couple more years. But I serviced this for you many, many years ago. And it's back now to get a reservice. One nice thing is something I couldn't do then, which I can do now, is have a stab at cleaning that hand loom. Bezel turns, it sure is all gummed up. You've been wearing this. You've really, really worn this. I'm going to be very curious to see how it held up. It's going to be fun. Put it in the vise. I certainly firmed that one down. Yep, there's my mark. It's not that long. It really is an honor to see it again. I did decent enough work to have it trusted enough to do the work again. Always happy to see work from customers again. Come on, get out. Whoops. This way.
It's weird. Why is there so much play in that fourth wheel? That was crazy. I'm going to be interested to find out what's up with that. Oh, really? Really? You got something broken in here? That sure wasn't. Let me find your note. Oh, come on. Here's that early dial, March 73 dated. What in the heck do we have going on? Why, that is just about the floppiest fourth wheel I've ever seen. Wonder what in the heck happened. Well, let's get to... I think we got a broken pinion on this one. Looks like, did this? And that's broken too. What in the heck happened here? Okay, well, that's loose. And that's loose. And that's loose. Did the whole thing just come up? Is the whole bridge loose? I can jewel that now. Couldn't do that before. We have our own jewel sets that are made only for us in the United States of America. I'm trying to see. I want to get the train to drop back in again. Well, let's just pull it, actually. Okay, the pinions are not broken. Is it just that the bridge was so loose that they just could flop around? I'm not seeing any pinion damage. See. How'd my jeweling hold up? Looks pretty okay. There's that. Mainspring. Clean those by hand. Good. Well, that's good. That's good. All these I have to clean by hand. And I have to swap out that jewel in the upper. And we are well past gasket time, so we're going to be rebuilding the case. Well, here's your main plate. Oh, I forgot to get this out. Get those cuteless works out here in a second. Stem rest washer. Spring. Heating up that crown to get the male stem out of it. Super important. Gotta let that cool down. That's a little hot. So in the meantime, put this back. Okay, well, this thing is apart. I've got to hand clean all this stuff. Okay. All right, so this now for me, I'm going to clean everything and then I will come back and we will go from there. Okay. So, we have a bad balance. If you look right here, right there, the pinion for the lower pinion for the balance is snapped off. So this balance is no good, bad stuff. So we have to replace the balance. I also am replacing your center wheel, and then I'm going to keep testing. Okay, new balance in. Let's see what our numbers are. So again, this is a new balance and a new center wheel. Your center wheel is just too much. Okay, I'm going to adjust this. First, I'm going to get rid of all that beat error. See if I went the right way or the wrong way. Ooh, I went the wrong way. So I'm moving the balance
bead error arm counterclockwise, which effectively lengthens the spring, which drops the rate. So now I'm pushing the rate up, and I'm going to hit that bead error again. Okay, almost ready. Let's hit that bead error again. Too much, maybe? Okay, let me drop that rate down. We're getting good numbers. I gotta go drop that rate some more. It's so nice when you find the problem. Oops, too far. Well, okay. Okay, I gotta adjust that down. Come on, I want to get the bead error to zero. The reason you're seeing this stuff is because I'm messing with the movement. It's hearing me play with the movement. It went the wrong way on the bead error. And now I'm going to go the rate again. Boy, getting that thing to drop to where I want it to is just... Damn it, too much. Almost. Come on, just a little bit more. Well, we've got excellent, excellent first numbers. This movement's only been running for a few minutes. And the numbers even out as the oil, you know, lubricants move into place and everything kind of settles back to where it needs to be. Well, that's some steady amplitude. I don't know why I'm watching these numbers. They're good numbers. Yep, it's doing well. This will be a great timekeeper. Yeah, okay. It's fun. Fun is fun, but let's get back. I'm going to let this continue to run. I'm going to work on the hands, cleaning those up. And there we are. Pretty happy with how it came out, the handset especially. It's still got some patina on it. I didn't want to push it too hard because you never know. Because one of the most important things is getting that metal hand surface nice again. Remember, it had black scunge all over it. Well, I got that off without damaging the plating. You still got some in the loom, but the loom generally looks way, way, way better than it did. Of course, you saw the numbers, you know how it's running. Your rotating ring now turns smoothly as it should through 360 degrees travel. It's a nice watch. I'm very glad to see it again. I'm glad I was able to clean up those hands. Isn't that nice? It's a great looking watch, and I'm looking forward to getting it back to you. Thank you so much.